guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. So today I have a get ready with me for you guys. First I'm going to start off by glossing up my lips because we want those to be good and moisturized by the end for my lip combo. So first I'm going to go in with my Morphe brow pencil. I believe this is in the shade Java. I'll have everything listed down below, but I'm going to do my brows first. Once I'm done filling them in, I'm going in with my Cover FX Power Play Concealer. I'll have the shade listed below. And yeah, we're going to clean up these brows, give them a nice shape, and we're going to move forward from there. Now I'm going to go in with my Milani concealer. This concealer recently, I've been showing it some love, honestly. It doesn't smell good. It honestly smells like paint to me, but I'm not mad at it. I've been using it a lot more lately. So yeah, I'm going to blend that all over my eyelids, and I'm going to set them using the Laura Mercier Honey Powder, and we're going to move on to the eyeshadow. Going in with my Morphe 3502 palette. Y'all know I love this palette so freaking much, but I'm gonna go in with that brown shade in my outer crease area. I'm gonna try to keep it in the outer crease. I'm gonna blend it a little bit onto the lid, but not so much on the lid, just really on that outer V corner. And yeah, this eyeshadow look is super simple. You know, I'm a soft glam girl. This is a soft glam channel, okay? That's what I like. That's what I do best, honestly. So, yeah. We're only using two shadows today. Real simple, real easy, real beginner friendly. And I'm going to just build this shade up until it is the brownness that I want. Thank you. And now I'm gonna go in and apply that light, like I guess cream color shade. I'm gonna put that all over the lid and then just go back in with that brown shade and just blend everything together real nicely, you know, no harsh lines, none of that. So yeah. So that is it. We're done with the eyes. I'm gonna go in with my Milk Hydro Grip primer and we're gonna apply that all over the face. And for today's foundation, I will be using the L'Oreal Infallible foundation. I've been really loving that foundation too lately, more than the others. It's just, I believe it's just the shade that I have. It really just matches my skin the best right now out of all of my foundations. So yeah. And it pretty much lasts me all day. It's definitely mask proof because it doesn't move around too much at all underneath my mask. It does get a little oily. I do have makeup in my mask once I take it off, but it's not nothing crazy at all. So yeah, I definitely been loving this foundation as well. All right, now I'm going back in with my Milani concealer. I don't know how I feel about the concealer under my eyes just yet because I feel like it be giving me creasing, but I just feel like my under eyes be creasing with any concealer, honestly. So I'm just like, I don't know if this is really the best concealer, but I've been liking it despite the smell. Now I'm gonna take my Laura Mercier translucent honey setting powder. Y'all, since I have gotten this powder, I have not put it down, okay? I be trying to use it sparingly so I don't run out so fast because I just got the travel size. I just wanted to try it out at first, but I have really been obsessed with this powder. Like, it just sinks into my makeup so seamlessly. Like, it's beautiful. And I will be repurchasing. There's no other powder that I really am interested in at this time besides, actually, maybe I would like to try the what powder is that? It's the I can't think of it right now, but for the time being, I'm gonna stick with Miss Laura, okay? She don't do me wrong ever. And now that I'm done setting that concealer, I'm gonna go in and set the rest of my face using my Sephora Micro Smooth Powder. Now taking my Fenty Beauty bronzer, I'm going to bronze. So now that I'm done bronzing and contouring my nose, I'm going to go in with my Cover FX blush. This blush, I've really been liking it. I have. This will probably be the only blush you ever see on this channel because it makes me happy. So, yep, just gonna blush the face. And now I'm going to set everything using my Morphe Luminous Setting Spray. I've really been loving this stuff as well. I mean, it's the only setting spray I have right now, but I really do like it. I like how it makes my makeup, you know, wear throughout the day. And now I'm going to go in with my LA Colors eyeliner for the eyeliner today. Thank you. And now I'm going to take my lashes from the brand Pretty and Ghetto. These are the style Cash. I will leave the Instagram link down below to where you can purchase these. These are my favorite lashes. Like, I've been wearing these same lashes. Well, this is the second pair that I got, but I love these lashes and they make my eyes look so pretty with any eye look, in my opinion. Anyway, applying the lashes real fast, real quick with the I use the black duo lash glue. And for my lip combo, you know, the regular degular KKW nude 3 lip liner and my nude ABH lipstick. This combo never does me wrong. I love it, and it's just always so pretty. It's just pretty. Now is time to move on to the hair portion of this video. I'm just gonna throw in some big loose curls. Nothing crazy. I curled the hair previously, like maybe a couple of days before me recording this. So that's why I just kind of wanted to go back in and recurl it just to get everything, you know, just more fresh, I guess you could say. I'm going in with my bedhead spray to lay down that lace really quickly, and yeah, I'm gonna go in with my hot comb, relay the roots of the closure. This is a closure sew-in I have right now, and I've been loving it. This hair is from Belle Thad Hair. I'll leave the link in the description to the hair company as well. She's black owned, and this is like raw Indian hair. Like, this is real hair. This ain't no AliExpress, this ain't no AliPearl, no none of that. This is like real hair, okay? So I'm so excited. I finally invested in this hair, and it has been treating me so well so far. I've had like absolutely like maybe one or two strands of like shedding. Like, it's been perfect. So I will definitely keep you guys updated on this hair. Oh, and by the way, I'm just going in with my Remington curling wand. I believe this is like a 1.5 inch barrel. I found it at Walmart. So yeah, I'm just gonna be curling my hair with this today. And I did not use any heat protectant today. I don't know what I was thinking. I wasn't thinking. But yeah, just make sure you guys use any heat protectant on whatever extensions or your real hair, you know, whatever it is. Thank you. All right, so this is the finished results with both sides. I'm just gonna run my fingers through the curls. Like I said, I didn't want like a super curled look. I just wanted it to be, you know, I wanted the curls to kind of really just fall into like a nice little like curl slash wave. I'm gonna go in with my Sebastian Shaper spray. This is just a little hairspray. I just did a little bit just to lay down a little bit of the flyaways. This hair really does not have many flyaways in the closure at all. And I'm just gonna spray the hair just a tad bit, not too much, because I don't want this hair to be like built up like product on it at all or anything. So yeah, this is my little outfit of the day, my wrinkled sweater, some jeans, and my Sperry's, you know, super casual. And for my body spray, I'm just going in with that little Bath and Body Works sweater weather body spray. But yeah, you guys, this is the final look of everything. Hope you guys enjoyed. See you in the next video.